वाइस चांसलर प्रोफेसर शाहिद मंसूर साहब, रजिस्ट्रार प्रोफेसर जाल अख्तर साहब, डॉक्टर नबी हसन साहब द लाइब्रेरियन, डीन्स ऑफ फैकल्टीज, प्रिंसिपल्स, कोलीग्स, अदर डिग्निटरीज, लाइब्रेरी स्टाफ, स्टूडेंट्स, स्कॉलर्स, लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, अ वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू. My heartiest wishes on the 148th birth anniversary of the father of the nation, Mahatma Gandhi. At the very outset, I would like to thank the Vice Chancellor and the university administration to consider me as one of the designated speakers on this prestigious occasion. We are talking of Mahatma Gandhi. We have been celebrating 2nd October as Gandhi Jayanti. We know Gandhi, the whole world knows Gandhi as the greatest freedom fighter of India, as the father of the nation, as a man, a soul who achieved the end through various impossible measures. Unbelievable. But there are certain questions that come to my mind. There are certain things that I would like to raise over here. Of course, not about Gandhi. Nobody can question Gandhi. My friends, other speakers, they spoke about the achievements and what they did. But my contention here today is to talk about how we perceive Gandhi. Gandhi was great. What are we doing? Are we following his steps? 2nd October is considered as Gandhi Jayanti in India when we remember, we honor, we pay homage to Mahatma Gandhi, the man. And since 2007, all the member states of the United Nations celebrate this day as the International Day of Non-Violence. What I'm trying to say is that India pays homage to the man, but the world pays homage to the ideas that Gandhi was. Gandhi today for us is more important as an idea and not simply or merely as a man. That is why in the recent few years, when certain things happened in the country, the media, there were debates and they asked whether is it an attack on the idea of India or the Gandhian ideas. So in 2017, when we are celebrating Gandhi Jayanti, this thing becomes all the more important. Gandhi, the idea that he was. I feel that Gandhi was no less than an enigma, an unbelievable person. If you look at his personality, his person, the physique, the appearance, he was weak, fragile, emaciated, you know, all the adjectives that you can use for a weak physique. But if you look at his actions, his personality, his beliefs, his ideas, they were just the opposite. He was strong, he was firm, he was committed, he was, you know, he was very persuasive, assertive, devoted, whatnot. So the appearance and the personality was very, you know, opposite to each other. Not only that, his ideas also. The second point I would like to say that we remember when we pay homage to Gandhi, we talk of all the good things and great things that he has done. But have we ever thought of that what struggles he has undergone in his own lifetime? There is hardly an idea or an action that Gandhi undertook in his lifetime was not opposed. When he thought of certain, fast in Calcutta, everybody said that no, don't go for fast. When he wanted to visit Noakhali in Bengal during the riots, people said no, don't go for that. Mahatma Gandhi was not accepted easily, but it was the firmness of Gandhi, that it was his commitment, that he went for that. Believe me, none of his ideas, or I can say in other words, that each of his ideas, be it about Muslim-Hindu unity, be it about truth, non-violence, everything was opposed and challenged at that time. But it was his persuasive nature, his ideas, his leadership that led people. So what happened at that time? That his ideas were not so easily acceptable, but the fellow companions, they were receptive to him, they accepted what he said and joined him. But at the same time, there was another force which always opposed him. And that is why we have a strange type of perception about Gandhi. And that is very much, prevalent nowadays in the present India, for example. It has become a fashion to say bad about Gandhi. To say bad about Gandhism. To say bad about freedom movement. So, what I am saying is that the forces that were there, which opposed him, his life, his actions, his initiatives, were not so smoothly, run in the country and India got the freedom. It was full of a struggle. And when I talk of a struggle, I also think of that, Gandhi, we always remember Gandhi as a freedom fighter, as somebody who was struggling against the British Empire. But let us look at it closely. He was struggling against two forces, at two levels, I would say. One, against the ills and sickness of the society which was prevalent in the country. And one of the most important thing was, that was the Hindu-Muslim, lack of Hindu-Muslim unity that he has been struggling over there. Our girl, she said about sati, swastha, cleanliness, how to behave, how to interact with others. What about minorities? What about Harijans? What about Dalits? What about education? What about language? What should be the language of instruction in India? He has talked on all the issues, on the issues which were important for the country, irrespective of the British Empire. So he was struggling at two fronts. One front was, the issues related to our own people. And the other was certainly, as we know, that is the British Empire. That was mainly the political front where he was fighting over there. I was talking to you about the conflicts. He was in favor of mother tongue for education. He was against English. And Tagore wrote about this thing, because Tagore was in favor of English and Gandhi was against English as a medieval instruction. And Gandhi was right, because all the developed countries today, the medium instruction in those countries are their own mother tongues. Think of Russia, France, Germany and all these countries. It is not English. So what I'm trying to say is that this man, he was almost like an enigma, easily, run in the country, and hence he had we had enemies at two levels. One was, of course, the British Empire, and the second enemy was our own people, Indians. They were also enemies because they were opposed to what he believed in, what he thought of, what he was speaking about in these things. So that is why, perhaps, Einstein said that in the times to come, he says, I will quote, generations to come, it may well be, will scarce believe that such a man as this one, ever in flesh and blood, walked upon the earth. His ideas and his actions have become almost unbelievable today, and Einstein was correct over there. Let us think of the man, you know, I will just list a few things. Think of the man, you are seeing some of his photographs, this photograph, as opposed to his early days photographs, seeing the poverty of the common mass, his adoption of dhoti as his dress, simply exceptional. It is not a simple, normal thing. He marched to Dandi on foot, inviting non-violent mass disobedience, and hence face to face with the mighty British Empire. His visit to Nuwakhali, Muslim-dominated area during riots, and his efforts were so concerted. You know, Nuwakhali, it's mainly Muslim-dominated area, that the riots were going on and Hindus were being affected. He went alone over there with a couple of people. He asked. Suchita Kulkarni, who accompanied her to him, she has narrated the whole thing, and which is there in which has been recorded by Madhu Dhanvate in his book. And where it is explained that what happened, he went there, he asked the people to come out of the house for compromising, you know, for finishing the rites. And the people, the elders, they didn't come. They were not coming out of the house. Then he attracted the children. He got hold of a ball and he started playing with that. And slowly the children came to him. And the children threw the ball to him, and then he started playing. Both Hindu and Muslim children. And hence he has said about this thing that your parents, the elder ones, they are more afraid of the situation than the children. And he gives a whole description about that. So look at his involvement into the things. He was not there in Delhi on 15th August 1947. You think of it. He's the father of the nation. He was the main person to achieve in attaining freedom for the country, but he was not present on 15th August 1947 in Delhi. So, you know, he had his own thoughts, his ideas, and he was so committed to that particular thing, and that commitment actually, that firmness, that belief in his actions, that made him, you know, bring us to the things. And I was just listening to one video the other day, 2-3 days back, and I could see, you know, that there is one on the YouTube. You'll find a share by a poem by Allama Iqbal, and which somebody was narrating that poem and was saying that it is where Allama Iqbal is condemning, is criticizing Mahatma Gandhi, and you know what happens there is that he calls Mahatma Gandhi a Hindu siyasi leader. Look at the perception, I'm talking about the perception. And he says that Muslim-Hindu unity, that call that was often tried upon by Gandhi, was a char. So you know, he's perceived differently by various forces. You see, one more point I would like to say, I need a couple of minutes, if you don't mind, please. The important thing is that Gandhi was not born a Mahatma. He was not born a Mahatma. Rather, through his experience, he was transformed, you know, as one who later came to be known as Mahatma. Yes, he died as a Mahatma. And therefore, his death becomes very important. Why he was killed? what made him die? Is that force which assassinated him finished, or is it now more, you know, available on the political ground? So when we remember Gandhi, we remember Gandhi for, you know, his for his birth, for his achievements, for his actions. But now is the time that we need to understand the struggles that he underwent and the way he was killed. That is what becomes more important. There is one thing I would like to say about his death, and which has been rightly said, that there is Allama Iqbal, he says, जिसमें की मौत कोई मौत नहीं होती, जिस मिट जाने से इंसान नहीं मर जाते, धड़कने रुकने से अरमान नहीं मर जाते, सांस थम जाने से ऐलान नहीं मर जाते, होठ जम जाने से फरमान नहीं मर जाते, जिसमें की मौत कोई मौत नहीं होती। Allama Iqbal was very correct that, of course, the body died, but the spirit, the idea that Gandhi was, did not die. And therefore, in the present time, when we talk of, you know, the whole binary has been developed. And in this binary, the soldier versus university students, secularism versus development, appeasement versus equality, these issues are being brought up in the nation. Institutions are being, you know, reshaped. So the whole new concept of nationalism has come. Incidents of lynching, lack of receptiveness, intolerance to dissent, engagement of media and photographic backcountry, new definitions of nationalism, sense of insecurity among minorities, and cases of intolerance and violence have become commonplace. I would also like to inform you that he was very much concerned about minorities. We hardly think of this thing. He says at one point of time that I will talk. When people say that you are Muslim supporter, you are working for the appeasement of Muslims, he said that I will talk of Muslims in India and Hindus in Pakistan. He was talking of supporting, giving a support to the minorities in the, you know, in the system. So, you know, in the given situation, what happens is that today, the unfortunate thing is that type of resentment, that type of dissent that was, you know, the opposition that was there has become very much prevalent in the society. And that is why I think it's a time that we all need to read Gandhi more and more. Let us not believe in what is being said over here. Let us explore it more. Let us read it more. It will be too late if we don't stand up and we come forward in the, you know, in understanding Gandhi. It is very important, you know, that we, especially, you know, the Muslims, that need to come forward in talking of Gandhi, because whatever is going on, it is, you know, the Gandhi's idea of India which is being opposed over here. And Muslims have always supported. In South Africa, it was Muslims who was with Gandhi, and then in India also, he has always been supported by Muslims in India. Muslims have to come forward at the national ministry, and we should join, you know, they should come up and they should speak and work on the lines of Gandhi. That is what is very important. I would like to stop my talk by reading Allama Iqbal. The one I quoted was Sahib Dudhrani. That was not Allama Iqbal. I'm very sorry about that. And that is what he said for Nehru. But I have quoted it for Gandhi because that is so apt, that is so appropriate over here. Now I will end by reading Allama Iqbal. वतन की फिक्र करो कर नादान मुसीबत आने वाली है, वतन की फिक्र कर नादान मुसीबत आने वाली है, तेरी बर्बादियों के मशवरे हैं आसमानों में, जरा देख इसको जो कुछ हो रहा है होने वाला है, मोहन के दास्तानों में ये खामोशी कहां तक, लज्जते फरियाद पैदा कर, जमीन पर तू हो और तेरी सदा हो आसमानों में, न समझोगे तो मिट जाओगे हिंदुस्तान वालों, तुम्हारी दास्तान तक भी न होगी दास्तानों में। थैंक यू वेरी मच।